this French proverb from Voltaire sums up my life pretty well. It means that it's not by staying at home that you will be open to the world, to knowledge, and to others. If I could talk to the child version of me, I would tell her to not overthink about the future, because most likely, it won't turn out the way she planned, and that's the beauty of it. I was born and raised from Quebec City, Canada. Quiet city, in which we jokingly called a big village because everyone knew each other. All of my family are French Canadians. I always thought, I feel like I belong elsewhere. My first exposure to the world was going to the United States. My mom brought me to Disneyland when I was 11, and I have traveled to the US a lot with my dad. It was so nice, especially when I visited New York. All of those cultures, so many people, and English everywhere. That's where I realized that I wanted to travel more. I was eager to discover the world and learn new languages. I have always been a big dreamer and an introvert. Even if I love to travel, I was picturing myself staying in my comfort zone. I also love to draw, and my parents saw me as a young artist. They have convinced me to go in that direction. Same story for my high school orientation class. They, without any further deeper analysis, recommended me to go study in 3D animation. My first heartbreak, my first disappointment, I had no fun at all. Everything I used to love, drawing, video games, animations, it became overbearing. I was not doing what I love anymore. It became a chore, a work. I suddenly felt nervous because I realized that my job prospects were small if I stayed in my hometown. Realistically, to have more job possibilities in the video game industry, I had to leave Quebec City, and I did not want to. My family, friends, all lived there. Also, I realized the importance of money. My parents were obsessed with money, always saying how life is expensive. My father was always talking about government jobs, how they were the best. Since the video game industry was no longer an option, I went for a bachelor degree in business administration. My life took a huge turn. I have discovered a lot about myself and was at the crosswalk of where I want to go with my life. And this is when I met him. We met on a dating app. I saw that he just arrived in the country and wanted to make new connections. I can't explain why, but I had a very good feeling. From his pictures, he seemed like a sincere man and he had a beautiful smile. We were both interested to meet, and that was the first time I got out of my comfort zone. He lived about 2 hours away from my hometown, but not a problem. I knew people there and I had a place to crash. Also, we knew nothing about each other's culture, and both had to converse in English, our second language, which brought us to cute shenanigans or, at worst, misunderstandings. And you know what is nice and why I believe in destiny? We bumped into each other, but not at the location we agreed to meet. It was totally random. So the date went super well. I was really attracted to his maturity and was curious about his story, his background, his culture. And it happens that deep in your gut. You feel like you really like that person and want to meet again. So this is what we did. The next weekend, he visited my hometown and we made it official. First cultural clash. I invited to stay over at my parents' place. You see, for us French Canadians, inviting a boyfriend home, even if the relationship is recent, is normal. It's very casual. But since I knew nothing about Korean culture at the time and how big of a deal it is to meet your partner's parents, it gave him a lot of pressure. Poor him. We are still laughing about it today. 3 months later, we were switching turns to see each other during the weekend because I was still studying and he had vocational school during the week. I visited him at New Year and something crazy happened. He proposed to me. At that same Starbucks we randomly met. I must admit that I was surprised, because that was fast.
It's suspicious!
I listened to my heart and said yes. Of course, people judged. Maybe he is using you for citizenship. It might come from a place of genuine concern, as gray marriages do happen. But I thought it was kind of rude to say that to me. Well, to those people I say, we are still together. If you wonder about the parents' reaction from both sides, well, although my parents were surprised because it is fast for Canadian standards, they were genuinely happy. My family absolutely loves him. Just like me, they are not used to being around other cultures and they were always curious and very interested in him. His parents also welcomed me with open arms. At first, I was intimidated by the language barrier, coupled with the cultural difference. But I couldn't ask for a better family-in-law. They are wonderful, warm-hearted people. They came to Canada for our wedding, and both my husband and I were happily surprised how well our parents got along, even though communication was near impossible. Although, when alcohol is involved, it's like everyone speaks the same language, right? Of course, an intercultural relationship comes with challenges. You have to make sure that a person shares the same core values. Also, the language barrier can cause some misunderstandings. That's why communication, like in all kinds of relationships, is essential. You also have to open your mind. Because the culture and environment we grow up in, we consider it the default. But we have to see life from other lenses, to consider other ways of talking. To be in an intercultural relationship when you are someone from a very homogeneous background is coming out of your comfort zone. When you overcome the previously mentioned challenges, it turns to something beautiful. We grow and we learn a lot from it. We deconstruct our prejudices and clichés. It brings out a lot of humanity. I left my hometown to live with him, so we discovered life in Montreal together, and later, we left the province of Quebec. I have traveled in Korea with him, stayed 3 months, and took a quick Korean language summer program. This was a great experience. Once again, I surpassed my expectations of myself. Because you see, I am a very anxious person, sometimes scared by my own shadow. The more I stayed, the more I felt comfortable to go around by myself, taking public transportation and reaching out to people in my third language. And this is why I love travel, the discoveries, the exchange with people. I did some volunteer work as well, and I am looking forward to doing more. I discovered a great country and culture, and great people as well. But the summer was totally painful, very hot. I'm sensitive to heat, so I had to be very careful. And there we are, 6 years of marriage already and a house later. We then decided to expand our family with that's right, a fur baby. It was unexpected, but we welcomed this beautiful baby girl in our life. We named her Tasha. If you wonder, what about a human baby? That's another subject for another video. This experience made me learn that, although, as a young person, you visualize and plan out roughly what kind of life you want. As a kid, I was going to be working for Disney and do animation. As a teen, I was going to be a surgeon, don't ask me why. Then in my early 20s, an animator again. Then an accountant. I was planning to live and die in my hometown as a 9-to-5 job with a French-Canadian man with 2 kids. Little did I know that my future husband was an ocean away, that I would spend months abroad and eventually end up moving away from my comfortable French-speaking village. And what about you? Have you thought about doing something that would bring you out of it, or you've done it already? Please, share with us in the comments!